It was not a loss of the turban alone. One Somabhupala was ruling the Gadwal Samsthana long ago. A king may be envious of a peer, but the Gadwal chief was jealous of a village accountant serving in his territory. He was of course aware of the wide gulf between his royal status and that of the Kulkarni. But what was the reason behind the royalty being green-eyed about an ordinary village accountant? Yes, there was a cause for it. The village Kulkarni, Seshappa, being a celebrity in the cultural circuit. Besides being appreciative of the talents of the artists engaged in fine arts, he used to encourage them wholeheartedly. He was a critic of music, drama and other fine arts, offering his comments in an unbiased manner, at the same time not wounding anyone. Seshappa's renown in the domain of fine arts had spread far and wide beyond his village Tharur. Apart from this, there was another reason for the Gadwal rulers' envy of him. Seshappa had a taste for sartorial excellence and was wont to wearing attractive dresses. Without a headgear called Urumal, he could never be seen outside. It was habitual for him to wear urumal of different designs and eye-catching colors. In those regions, such headgear commanded respect and a kind of worship, and people used to touch it with awe and reverence if Seshappa removed it from his head and kept it aside. They considered such veneration of the accoutrement as an exhibition of their obeisance to Seshappa himself. Even while an official errand to Gadwal, he used to go with such pomposity. When the Gadwal ruler saw him for the first time, he thought that some chief of another territory had come to meet him. And when it was known that it was the Tharur Kulkarni, his blood boiled at the ostentation of a mere village accountant in his presence. Later, during every visit to Seshappa, the Gadwal ruler's envy of him burgeoned, particularly when he learnt of Seshappa's popularity in society. While so, on one occasion, there was some unavoidable delay in the remittance of money to the Gadwal Samsthan, as Seshappa had been held up for 2 days at a place he had gone on a visit to in connection with a cultural program. Availing of the opportunity of Seshappa's failure to carry out his obligation in time, the Gadwal ruler asked his minister to bring Seshappa to the court at once. Despite Seshappa volunteering to present himself before the king, he was dragged unceremoniously and presented before the royalty. A minister then asked Seshappa, "The amount collected by you has not been remitted to the Samsthana immediately. The royalty wants to know why it has been delayed." "O Lord, it was held up because of the sudden development of certain unavoidable circumstances." "Is it the preparation for your sartorial adornment that has delayed your coming here by 2 days?" asked the king, evoking the ironical giggle of the entire court. "It's not so, my lord. From outside, I..." Even before Seshappa could finish telling what he intended to express, the Gadwal chief interjected, "Yes, for this kind of makeup and dressing, helping hands from outside will have to come, and perhaps the delay in their arrival has caused 2 days to run out," sending the courtiers to a hilarious laughter. Seshappa wanted to tell, "O lord, have I done like this any time before?" But when he was halfway through the expression, the royalty mockingly observed, "Are you going to tell that you require 2 more days for your flotulent attiring, seeking extension of time till then?" leaving the courtiers stunned and speechless. Seshappa kept silent, thinking that the king will not be convinced of by any of his submissions. "You have committed a mistake and were answering my questions till now, but have become tongue-tied all of a sudden. Why is it so, Seshappa?" Seshappa did not say anything to this also. "Seshappa, without knowing your status, you are pretentious. Yes, you are haughty and your swollen head needs to be stunted, said the Gadwal chief and signaled to at an attendant. The henchman then went and stood near Seshappa. The gathering there and Seshappa too could not know what would happen next and were keenly watching the proceedings. And lo, in an instant, the king's orderly swatted the urumal from the head of Seshappa and it flew and fell at a distance. Seshappa was shocked by the incident and so too the others. Without wasting further time, remit the amount and leave the place. If there be a recurrence of such lapse, the penal action could be quite serious, said the king and left the hall with a sense of pride, as if a battle had been won by him. The assemblage then dispersed, looking at Seshappa piteously. With innumerable thoughts passing through his mind, Seshappa then stood there like a statue. Oh, what a mortification is this, that too in the king's court. Apart from wounding my heart with words of mockery and insult, my headgear has been swatted, rendering me bareheaded. Oh, how many people would have touched this urumal with veneration and in worship. Every day I used to wear a variety of headgears at different times, which had given me an aura of dignity. I have never faced such humiliation in my life. One or two days delay in payment of the collection is nothing uncommon, and I have seen some others also remitting their monies with some delay. Have they all been punished in this manner? This is a castigation done with pre-planning and a deliberate intent. The news of these happenings would have by now spread in the entire Gadwal, and before I reached Tharur, my abashment in the royal court should have been known there also. I have always been holding my head high, and now what a shame has befallen me, making me crestfallen in the presence of my admirers. Oh, there is none in this courtroom now, except me and my urumal lying at a distance. Can I take it? No, let me not do that. It looks as if I have been beheaded. In fact, if such guillotining had been executed, I would not have been alive to ruminate over all these. Seshappa then moved out of the hall solemnly. Without picking up his urumal, he started walking along the road to Tharu. A lion that he was in his gait, surrounded by many admirers, he was reduced to nothing in just an instant and had to walk alone with drooping shoulders towards his village. Is destiny so harsh as to bring misfortune unannounced? Is this not the propitious time for ethicality and goodness in this world? What requires to be borne in mind in this context is that if the virtuous ones should be facing some adversity, it only forebodes something good following such misfortune, signifying some special divine grace to come next. But human mind being what it is, the general tendency would be to rue why something bad has happened, despite being devout and worshipful towards the Almighty. Adverting to Seshappa's plight, he could not tread further and stopped at a place on the way to Tharur. The road was branching off at that spot in two different directions. Seshappa took the one on the right side that was leading in the direction opposite to the locale of Tharur. Where he went from there and what for he proceeded in that direction and his strange experiences following that find narration in the next chapter.